Good morning. The reality of being 39 weeks pregnant. I am about to make some hard-boiled eggs and an English muffin for breakfast. Ooh. It's really uncomfortable to sleep at this point. I did not sleep very well last night at all. I'm gonna make 3 hard-boiled eggs this morning. I just peeled my eggs and I'm gonna make one of these cinnamon raisin English muffins. I like to put these just in this little like toaster air fryer thing we have with butter and strawberry jam, and it is so good. Salt, pepper, garlic powder, cayenne pepper. Literally the only way that I can eat hard-boiled eggs. Give them that flavor. My snacks at work today. Jalapeno chips, a big bag. So last night I was dying for some cheesecake, but the closest cheesecake factory is like 25 minutes away from where I live. So I went to Fresh Market and got a cheesecake and some strawberries, because you gotta give in to the pregnancy cravings. I haven't really had any like crazy weird pregnancy cravings. It's more so just like towards the end, it's been more sweets for sure. Like I have been living for ice cream, cheesecake, fruit, like all of that. On the same side, these chips are like the best thing in the world. I'm taking this cheesecake with a couple strawberries, some chips, a banana. I'm trying to think. I'm gonna be there a little bit longer than usual today. I'm going in earlier. Ooh, I am gonna take, I got these little cans of pineapple juice. I heard that pineapple is also supposed to be something really good to help encourage labor. So this is 100% juice, not from concentrate, no added sugar. So yeah. How cute. I just cut up the strawberries and put it in a container with it. That's gonna be good today. I feel like this week's gonna be like super chill. I would absolutely love if I have a baby by the end of this week. But he's been so stubborn this whole time, so I doubt he's gonna bless us with his presence early. He's gonna make us wait until the last second. But look at my maternity scrubs. You can actually like see my belly in it now. I was so excited when I found out that you can have coffee during pregnancy, up to 200 milligrams of caffeine a day. So I do a 10 ounce medium roast, which I think is like 150 milligrams of caffeine or something like that. I don't know. I stay under the 200 mark, but it's still very, very refreshing to know that I can get some comfort and some energy even throughout pregnancy. So I've been drinking coffee. Like I drink coffee Monday to Friday my whole pregnancy, because I would not make it through these work days without it. And I use dairy-free almond milk creamer, vanilla flavored, and it's so good. I'm trying to hype myself up for the day. I'm trying to. Part of me really, really wants him to come like this week and ASAP. Then the other part of me is like, I really want to work as long as I can. Since I'm an entrepreneur, I don't get paid leave. And then at this office that I'm working at, I'm part-time, so I also don't get paid leave from there either. So yeah, I have been saving my money like crazy so that I can take as much time as I need after baby's born. But yeah, getting like 1 or 2 more checks would definitely be nice. Getting myself together and getting out of the door gets me out of breath. I really try not to think too much about the fact that I could have a baby any day now, because if I think too much about it, it really stresses me out. Like, it gives me anxiety, and it's like, whoa,
from the second I found out I was pregnant, I knew my life was never gonna be the same. But now that it's actually here, like, it's crazy. Everything changed. My life will literally never be the same. I never really pictured this for me. Like, you know how you talk to women and they have this like vision of what they want their life to be like, and oh, I want to be a mother, I want to be a wife. I've never really just had that desire, had that like, oh, I see this for myself. Like, I never saw this for me. I never didn't see it. Like, I feel like I've always just been a really open book, I guess, to whatever could happen in life. I've never necessarily like wanted or needed things to be a certain way. But yeah, motherhood was just something that like, I'm like, yeah, I'm made for this. Like, I know I could do it, but I never saw it actually happening, especially so soon. I say so soon, I'm 25. I turned 26 this year, so I mean, it's still just, it's crazy to think about. My life has just been crazy. I think it's really important that we take time to reflect on like how we ended up in the positions that like we're in currently. Just taking time to like actually self-reflect on what's going on right now. I feel like because I get so like easily prone to being anxious and having a lot of anxious thoughts, that's why I try not to like think too far ahead into the future or stress about like what could happen in my life or what should happen in my life. So living in like the right now is something that I've really had to teach myself, and self-reflecting and appreciating what's going on currently and not stressing about what has happened before or what is to come in the future has really brought me like a lot of peace. And when I find myself kind of sinking back into like stressing about what has happened or what could happen, I get anxious and I hate that feeling. I absolutely hate it. I used to let myself like drown in anxious thoughts, but since I got pregnant, like, I'm not allowing that to happen to me anymore, because the level of responsibility that I have to teach my child like emotional intelligence and to teach them good values, good morals, like, I cannot be worried about what is or what is not. Like, I gotta live for right now, and I gotta trust the process of everything, because when you think about it, like, God has pulled you out of every tough situation in life.
I got my trays with my rubber bands in. It's been busy today, but it's Monday. I'm the only person up at the front on Mondays. I'm trying to take my time with my snacks, but now that I have my trays in, like, it's hard. But I'm definitely about to take them out and eat my cheesecake, because I want my cheesecake. So I told you guys earlier, I don't get like paid leave from this job just because I'm part-time, but I'm gonna be working from home for a couple days a week. So I'll probably start that. I just gotta see how I feel after I give birth. Like, and it's crazy because nobody here ever knows that I'm pregnant, because like look from the side, but like if you just saw me. I'm gonna be working a couple days from home, just doing insurance stuff, and everything like that. And I don't know, when it comes to work after baby, like, I really would love to take my training business mostly online and then continue here part-time, just because I like the stability of everything here. I'm really anxious about navigating work postpartum. I'm really thankful that I have my family, my parents, who are like working with me with a schedule. So I don't have to do daycare. So my mom's gonna be my child care for two of the days of the week, but yeah, daycare is like crazy expensive. And if I can't even afford like rent right now somewhere, rent and daycare, I don't know how people are doing it. I really don't. I'm like super on my own with everything, so like financially. So yeah, I just have to make sure that
I'm saving my money and doing as much as I can. But y'all, when I tell you the word of this year is consistency, we're gonna make it happen. We're gonna make it happen. And I want y'all to remember this video when I'm talking about all this, when it happens, okay? I want everybody to thrive and do well. And I feel like there's so much room for all of us to do it. We just gotta put the work in. That's been the biggest thing for me. I got to put the work in, got to stay consistent with it. And that's exactly what I'm doing this year. And my son is the biggest motivation for me now to make that happen. But let me get back to work.
Workout. 10. Good. What day is, oh, today's Monday.
Yeah.
This is our first workout of the week. Yes. To your rows. Row your boat.
Where am I going?
To your Carrie Underwood legs.
Yes. I'm coming.
This is what I do while she works out. Lay here with my belly. Is that it?
That's it?
No.
Two, I did two sets.
Yeah, but we're gonna do a core exercise. Weights above the head. And then, yeah. And then you're gonna march. Get your knee up. Yeah. And hold that above head like this. And then march. Keep your arms straight.
I feel like I'm marching to somewhere.
Keep your arms straight.
I can't. That's yes, you, straight.
Yes, you can.
I am so exhausted right now. I'm on my yoga ball. I am excited though. There's some updates. I think like it's so crazy because now like that I'm towards the end, really small things just make me so excited. When I was about to take a shower, I noticed that I've like started leaking. I think it's colostrum, but yeah, I saw that it was like stained and I got hype. I was like, I don't know. I want to breastfeed really bad. Or at least try to. And I just feel like that's a good sign. And also, I did notice I'm starting to get stretch marks. So I have stretch marks like under my boobs and then also on my sides. I haven't noticed anything on the belly yet. But yeah, underneath you could see just little things that just makes me excited. So I'm excited. I'm about to do my Bible study. So right now, I have been in the book of 1 Corinthians, and this, honestly, you see how many notes I've been taking. So I've gotten through chapters 1 to 6, so since I'm so tired, I don't want to lose my focus too much, so I'm probably just going to do chapter 7, kind of like recap what's going on in the notes that I've taken so far. Starting with the first, my main notes and my main points. So it's Paul speaking. He's trying to correct the wrong attitudes and the behaviors of the Corinthians, and he's urging unification. Oh, there's a section talking about divisions in the church, and he's really putting a heavy emphasis in chapter 1, verses 10 to 17. That all the focus should be on Christ, not one teacher versus another, which I feel like is huge because pastors, people on social media, like anybody you run into, they're vessels of the bigger picture. They're vessels. The focus is on God. The focus is on Christ, not who's delivering the message. And it talks a lot about like worldly people and how God will shame people who reject faith in Christ. So like people who are very worldly and who are looking for like high status and everything like that. And then it talks about how God's ultimate wisdom can only be understood spiritually. Y'all know I get out of breath. Oh my gosh. And then that goes into chapter 2. I thought this was really, really good because it talks about how being saved does not make you spiritual. And I wrote the question down, how are you living your life? Because you can be baptized, you can go to church, you can say that you're a Christian, you can say a lot of things, but how are you actually living your life? How do you treat other people? What What do you talk about? Like, what are you actually doing in your life that is serving God? I feel like that was a really good, like, I had to stop and like really think about that question. Like, how am I living my life? Am I actually living my life spiritually? Because like I said in the first chapter, God's ultimate wisdom can only be understood spiritually. We got to live our lives in a way that's going to glorify God. This was really good too, because I feel like this bleeds a lot into what I have going on in my life currently with work and consistency. So in chapter 2, it talks a lot about the quality of work that you do, and that God makes things happen, but it requires us to work. So I'll read this. It's chapter 2, verse 6 to 8. It says, I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the growth. So neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. So basically, he's given us the seeds. He's given us the tools to garden. He's given us everything we need, but we have to actually take that. We have to plant the seeds. We have to use the tools God gave us, and we have to plant them, and then God provides the growth. He gives us what we need, and then he provides us with the end product. But in the middle, we have to put in the work. Later on in that chapter, it talks about, so they were laying a foundation to build, what were they building? Oh, they were laying a foundation for a building, and God said that he was going to send a fire to test the work that they have done for the building. So basically about the quality of our work, and that when we put our work on the foundation of Christ, we will be rewarded. The fire is not going to tear us down. The fire is going to show, no, we built this with the foundation of Christ and you can't tear it down. Probably my favorite chapter so far that I've read out of 1 Corinthians. Really needed to hear that. Chapter 4 talks a lot about judgment and to not judge each other, and that only God can judge. And then, Paul really in chapter 4 is trying to be a spiritual example. And so that led me, I wrote the question down, are you an example of the goodness of God? So look at how you're living your life, look at what you're promoting, look at what you're doing in your day-to-day. Are you an example? Are you being a good person? Are you, you know, like living your life? Of course, obviously nobody's perfect and we all sin and we all have our shortcomings. It's never going to be perfect, but just stuff to think about. Whew. Chapter 5 goes along heavily with what I talked about in my last video about abstinence. It talks a lot about sin, sexual immorality. But even on top of sexual immorality, it talks about, like, it connects that to just sin as a whole, and basically saying that you need to remove the sin around you. About greed, it talks about idolaters. Is that how you pronounce it? Idolaters? You know what I mean? People who idolize worldly things. But basically, big point of chapter 5, purge the evil person from among you. So who are you surrounding yourself with? You are who you hang around. You are who you're around. And then chapter 6, still talking about the sexual immorality and sin. And I made the note, it's not about what is lawful, but what is helpful. So do the things that you're doing in your life or the people that you're surrounding yourself with serve you. And it talks a lot about self-control. The body is not meant for immorality, but it's meant for the Lord. You become one with your sexual partners spiritually. So that's something I feel like I did not really, like, pay a lot of attention to just in my younger years up until now. You really do. Like, you, it's a soul tie. That's what it is. It talks about respecting your body and how your body's a temple. You can connect that with health and wellness and fitness and taking care of yourself from a fitness standpoint. And then also, you know, like, that's really big motivation too for fueling your body properly, for, you know, making sure you're drinking enough water throughout the day, making sure you're eating as good as you can, you know, as often as you can. The 80-20 rule, just treating your body with respect overall. That's a big reason why I'm on my abstinence journey and why I do
choose to fuel my body because I want to show myself that I respect myself, and I want to show God that I respect the body that He's given me. So choosing to glorify God with my body, that's why I'm here. Right, and now we're going to do chapter 7. I'm excited because actually 1 Corinthians has been great. Love it. So I don't really remember. I think I just turned to a random page and ended up at 1 Corinthians. So yeah, but I'm going to go do that. And then I am dead tired. I literally feel like I got hit by a ton of bricks right now. We're getting so close to the end. But I have a doctor's appointment in the morning, so I get to sleep in a little bit. And then I'm going to head to the doctor's appointment. So I'll let you guys know how it goes tomorrow.
We're going to my doctor's appointment. Oh wait, I don't even think you're in focus.
Good morning.
Morning. I'm gonna ask her about the membrane sweep today. So we'll see how that goes. We all have this baby within 48 hours. She doesn't want me to.
Yeah,
babe. I love when my mom could come with me to my appointment.
We'll slow down. I don't get to walk today.
She's speed racing through traffic if you can't.
She's getting undressed for her appointment right now. Good morning. She's waiting for her checkup.
I'm asking about the sweep. What if it makes me go into labor? Some people said that it did, like, the same day. And then some people said 48 hours. And then some people said it didn't do anything for them, but just caused pain.
Okay. So we're still 1 centimeter. Just one. And we can go this way. I asked about the membrane sweep. So at my appointment next week, she says she would do it if I'm coming back next week. Hey, did we really park all the way back here? Oh my gosh. So next week, she'll do the membrane sweep. She said she did kind of get in there, right here. She says she kind of did get in there and manipulate around the cervix a little bit. So we'll see how it goes next week.
But guys, I'm hyped. I can get a membrane sweep next week, and I really, really hope that it works for me. So with the membrane sweep, I've seen a lot of people say that they went into labor the same day, within 48 hours. Or there were a couple people that said that it didn't do anything for them and it was just uncomfortable. But honestly, my cervical check today, it didn't hurt or anything at all. It felt just like a regular vaginal exam. So the last two cervical checks, like, they didn't hurt. Like, it wasn't how I expected it to be. Because a lot of people on TikTok scared the crap out of me about these cervical checks. And they were like, oh, it's so uncomfortable. It's so painful. Like, there's discomfort, but like, there's a lot of things in pregnancy that are just uncomfortable. So cervical check wasn't anything like so insanely crazy to me personally, but today was the third check and it was fine. I'm a little disappointed that I'm still only 1 centimeter and I'm not really having any signs or anything, but I am happy. She said she kind of went it, like, she manipulated a little bit in there. Didn't do a full membrane sweep. A membrane sweep is when they like go in and like go their fingers in a circle and separate your amniotic sac, I guess, from the cervix. I don't know, they basically just go in with their fingers and like do a circle. And that's supposed to induce labor, or for some people it does. So hoping I'm one of those people. Hoping this is my last week being pregnant. I love it. I feel so beautiful in my body right now. But it's definitely uncomfortable, and I just want to meet my baby. I want to get us in a routine.
Simmer! I'm taking my dog to orientation this evening for dog training, because he needs to get himself together before Maverick gets here.
My biggest goal that I want to do with him is to learn loose leash walking and recall. What else? And barking. Less barking. Yeah. Getting distracted. Overall, I just want him to listen better to, like, when he's called and when he's told to do something. Because he's really smart. He picks and chooses when he wants to do well and when he doesn't.
Ain't that right, my booger? You pick and choose.
Yeah. So, we're going to Holiday Barn Pet Resort, and they offer, like, different training packages, but they require you to do an orientation before you actually do anything. So, we'll see how it goes.
You ready for orientation? Are you ready? He knows he's going to school.
No. Simba is going to be starting his school soon. Honestly, really loved this place that I'm taking him to. They are pricey, but pretty much all dog trainers that I have been looking into are pricey. I really want to get Simba trained. He's so smart and such a good dog, but I personally just don't know how to take him to that next level that I know that he can get to. So he's right here. So yeah, I feel like investing into this training service is gonna be super beneficial. So I'm gonna board him for 1 week and then he's gonna do the day school for another week. They recommended a 2 week program for him. I'll definitely keep y'all updated on how it goes for that. They're gonna be teaching him basic commands, loose leash walking, trying to get him to be not as reactive. So I'm just really hoping for the best, especially with baby gonna be here soon. I need him to be like as put together as possible. So I think that this is really gonna be good. They did say like you still gotta work with them at home and everything. Like it's not a like 100% problem solver. You still have to put the work in at home. So I'm prepared for that. I'm gonna take the stuff that they teach me at the end of each week and just do what I can with him at home. So yeah, I'm excited he's gonna start that. I definitely waited super late to do this. I probably should have done this a while ago, but I kind of just put it off because it is pricey, but I definitely feel like it's worth the investment. It ends up, the total for the 2 weeks is gonna be like $1,000, which is pretty much like what I've been quoted from a lot of other places. But I felt really comfortable with this place. Everybody was great. The facility is amazing. So yeah, I think it'll be awesome. We're still pregnant today. I'll let you guys know how I feel tomorrow. But I am hoping that after I get this membrane sweep next week that it'll work for me. Fingers crossed. All right. It's workout time. I'm joining in on the workout today. Last time here, and then we'll do our 90 degree.
All both of them?
Yeah, and then get your arms up. Yeah, and then drop opposite arm, opposite leg at the same time. No, but keep the other arm in the same place.
Oh.
Yeah, and then bring it back to the center. No, bring it back to the center first.
I'm confused.
Drop the opposite arm, opposite leg. Yep. And then but you want to keep 90 degrees and then get it out a little bit. Do one more on each.
Simba!
These are not for us, apparently.
I'm doing it!
Okay, there you go. And now the dogs are done. Alright, what workout of the week is this? Number two?
Number two of the week.
Workout number two of the week that I joined in on a little bit.
Good.
Feeling good.
I feel it in my core right now. That's what I need. I just gotta be careful.
What's going on, Zimmer? Uh-oh. Ready? Go! snow. What's going on, Simmies? It's snowing. I'm late for work. I ever slept. I was having the craziest dream. Having a dream about labor and delivery, but like it wasn't for me. My alarm went off and I woke up and I was like, it was so bizarre. I don't know what's gonna be worse, pregnancy tired or newborn tired. So we'll see. I've heard 50-50 responses. Like some people say that newborn tired is worse. Some people say pregnancy tired is worse. I don't know, but I'm tired. But my body is definitely preparing me for waking up several times a night because that's all I do now. So I feel like I don't ever just get like a good night's sleep. I guess I could say bye to that for a while. Him, it's covered in snow. Simmy, what is
this? You did?
Yeah.
We are making shrimp and scallop linguine with a white wine and tomato paste, garlicky sauce.
Are you recording?
Yeah. I'm having a rough day. I'm having a very rough day. So bear with me, you guys. Today has not been good.
Can you put that piece in the garage?
But I really wanted this pasta, so I think this is gonna be great. The only thing I forgot to get is shallots. But we have some onion, we got the garlic, tomato paste, using cupcake, sauvignon blanc. The stare that I got from the employee, because my stomach was out. My stomach was out and he like looked at me. He was like, you got ID? I almost wanted to say something and be like,
I'm cooking.
I'm cooking, I'm not drinking this. Can't forget the lemon. Yeah. So, it should be really good.
A lot of baby ones.
A lot of pasta's going on this plastic. Oh, 10 to 11 minutes, so that'll be perfect.
Perfect timing.
What is going on right now? Everything is just overwhelming. Emotions get really tough at this time, especially because it's just been me and my family my whole pregnancy. And I hate when people just don't understand the level of like hurt that they've caused you. It's really upsetting, especially somebody that you have no choice but to deal with. After I give birth, my papa is coming. That's my grandma. She's gonna make me, what is the soup?
It's just like a bone broth soup with a lot of veggies.
A veggie bone broth soup because it's supposed to help with your milk supply.
Hey. Like a big old thing of chicken patties.
No, I'm gonna go get some chicken breast and stuff.
Let's add noodles. Just using a fork to get all them under there. Adding in the seafood. So let that cook down. Noodles we're gonna do for 10 minutes. Saute the seafood with some oil just until it's like almost done.
Then I'm gonna strain it because there's gonna be a lot of excess water. Then we'll add it back, do the butter, garlic, onion, tomato paste, white wine, make the sauce, all that stuff. It's gonna be.
You see, just lots of water.
So we're gonna drain it. 2 tablespoons of butter and then a little bit more oil. Add the onions. Everything kinda glaze. Then once it becomes fragrant, usually just a couple seconds, I'll add the seafood back. And I did clean this off, this strainer. Make sure we check on our pasta. About a couple more minutes. I'm gonna do salt. What you doing? Pepper. Chef Kate! It's time to add tomato paste. Diced tomatoes. I don't want too much of the juice. Just a little bit. Smelling good. And we'll add some, just a little bit, crushed red pepper. I promise there's not that much coming out of here right now. Now we add the white wine. I got the cupcake Sauvignon Blanc. Even the smell of wine is so strong to me right now since I haven't had any alcohol. So, gotta let that cook for 5 minutes again just to get all the alcohol out. It smells really good though. The nudes are done. I just reserved a little bit of pasta water. I'm gonna go ahead and add it. Just to thin the sauce some. Noodles drained. Alright, gonna put this on low. Real good. Gonna add some more pepper and salt. Add a little bit of garlic powder too, just because I love garlic. Alright, dinner. Made it with a little bit of Italian seasoning. I'm gonna put a little bit of oil in the noodles just so they don't stick. Lemon juice ready. My nose is sensitive to this alcohol smell.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. It's cooking down. I'm gonna give it about another minute. We're gonna stir the noodles in. The noodles.
This is a lot going on right now.
What the?
Not with the bread. For our bread, we got the struggle bread. It's literally garlic and butter spread on some bread. I honestly prefer this over regular garlic bread. Like, it's so good. Literally garlic powder and butter. Try it, it's the best thing ever in our pasta. It only took us long to make because I had a breakdown.
That's okay.
But now we're eating. one thing about me, or one thing about, I guess, our family,
I love to use a paper plate and a plastic fork.
All right.
Get your money up.
Right.
I know, you might have slightly overcommitted.
I think I overcommitted.
I like to cook.
I'm happy for you to cook.
It's just, I know, it's been hard in my pregnancy.
I know. That's why I haven't had you do anything.
Wanting to cook, but I do miss it a lot.
Bread.
Simba will grab that.
I know, I gotta move it. I had to set it down real quick.
He will grab it.
You're not supposed to have candles.
Two pieces.
You ain't supposed to have extension cords either.
Watch out, I gotta move it. Watch your... I better bless this food.
That tastes just like what I get at Carrabba's.
Does it?
The shrimp and scallop linguine a la vodka. So I guess they use like a vodka sauce, but that tastes just like it.
Dude.
Oh, it's a tomato white wine sauce, and it's so easy to make.
It's a tomato wine.
Super easy. Mm-hmm. That's good.
Well, let's get into this tea while I do my nighttime routine. No, I'm just kidding. It's not tea. So I've been struggling. Some people who... Ooh, if you follow me on my Instagram or my TikTok, you may have seen a little bit of what I've talked about, kind of my situation and why I was having a breakdown earlier. I'm not with my child's father. And we have not been together. My whole pregnancy, and my issue with it is that he does not take accountability for anything. Like, my family has been here for me this whole time, like this entire time. My family, they've been the ones like riding for me. He just like pops up and will pop in and like make demands, and he thinks I'm like so evil because I don't want him at the hospital when I give birth, but it's for a reason. Like literally from when I was like, before my even first appointment, when I was like 6 weeks pregnant, it was just a hot mess and I didn't feel safe with him. It's just hard when I like constantly get blamed for stuff, or like blamed for trying to protect my headspace, because it took me a long time to even get to this point. Like, I never used to set boundaries for myself and like respect them, and pregnancy has definitely taught me to do that. And it doesn't matter who that's with. I'm gonna set boundaries and I'm gonna respect them. If they're not gonna respect them, I'm going to. So they're still gonna be met. But I used to talk a lot on social media about, you know, like what I was dealing with and what I was going through with that situation. But then it got flipped around on me. Like, I was the problem, and for airing my business out and trying to ruin his business and all of that. I don't want to be put in that light, because I'm not trying to ruin anybody, but it's been really hard for me. It's been really, really hard. And the only people who like truly understand is like women who have also gone through it. But I don't know, I gotta protect myself. And I definitely have done a lot better job of not letting him get to me and not letting the situation get to me. Everybody in my house right now wanna talk. I'm trying to talk to y'all. So let me take you to the beginning. When I found out I was pregnant, we were kind of on and off, and obviously I didn't want to be in this position. There's been times throughout my pregnancy where I've wanted to try to make it work, but then it's like, when somebody shows you who they are, it's not necessarily like showing you who they are as like, as in they're like a bad person, but sometimes like with relationships, if somebody just cannot meet your needs,
Like, you can't force somebody to do things that you're looking for. I feel like that was just the case with my relationship. We were just very different. With the relationship not working out, like, the pattern that I've seen is just, like, because the relationship is not working, like, I feel super left alone in this pregnancy. Any help that I've gotten, I've had to ask. Like, nothing has just been taken initiative for, and it's even been said, like, oh, well, if we were in a relationship, then I would do this, and I would do this, and it's like, how can you think that way when there's, like, literally a child involved? So a lot of it for me is just really frustrating, and I'm really nervous to be a single mom, especially because I've been threatened with court and all of this, like, my whole entire pregnancy, and I'm, like, not even doing anything as far as, you know, allowing my child's father to be a parent. The baby ain't even here yet, but, like, I've not said anything that would indicate that I'm gonna keep him from being a father. So it's been really rough to have to stress and, like, have anxiety about, like, oh my gosh, well, what is it gonna be like when the baby's actually gonna be here? That's why, like, I want my baby to be here, but I am really cherishing this time that it's just me and him, because I'm honestly scared about what's gonna happen. I'm scared about everything that I say because I don't know what he's gonna do. Like, and it's just, it's not fair that I have to, like, worry about these things, and I've had to worry about these things throughout my whole pregnancy. And it's really rough. It's really rough. I've always been, like, a very vulnerable and transparent person, especially on social media, just because I'm not a very social person in real life, and I've always had comfort in, like, meeting people through social media who have gone through similar things in life as me. I don't know, it's just opened up and connected me to people that I just never would meet in person. That's why I've always chosen to be, like, open and vulnerable on my socials, and this has kind of put me into a box. It's not easy. So, it's like things that have been said to me, done to me, like, this is why I'm so thankful for my family for opening up their home to me again, like, after I was out on my own living in my apartments for years. They accepted me back into their home. They were kid-free in this house, and now they got me and baby. But my mom's been to every appointment with me, and I stress how much I love my family so much, because they've been the ones to pick me up this whole time. Like, they've been the ones, every time I come home and I'm in tears, when I'm having breakdowns in the middle of the night, they're the ones that are there. My mom's the one that's at my appointments with me. My mom's the one that's gonna be in the hospital room with me. Like, they have been there. They've been the ones who take care of my dog when I'm too tired, or when I'm working a long day and I need help. They've been the ones to take care of him. They've been the ones to provide me with food when they know that I'm getting off work late, or I've worked a 13-hour day and they have food for me at the house. Like, they've been the ones to do that. I love them so much. 'Cause I literally would not have made it through this without them. Like, I definitely wouldn't have. So my biggest advice, 'cause through this process, when I was sharing a little bit more on my social media about it, I was able to connect with a lot of women who have been in similar situations, and it's really sad. Like, nobody's perfect. We're not perfect. Like, I've said things and reacted in ways that I definitely shouldn't have, and I'm aware of that. We all have our shortcomings. Sometimes we're provoked to get to a certain point, but, like, as women going through pregnancy is already hard. It is so freaking hard already on our bodies, on our minds, like, our spirit changes everything about us as a woman. Like, we will never be the same as we are before we get that positive pregnancy test. And it's a lot. And I feel like some people like never take the time to truly think about how much it is on us. And we're just doing our best. We're doing our best, and we deserve more during this time. We deserve more care postpartum. We deserve more love. We deserve more understanding. And that's the biggest thing with me. We just deserve more during this time. Like, we really do. We're doing something so incredible, so difficult, and it completely alters our life. Like, men don't have to change the way that we have to change. No, it's so hard because I want to tell you guys so much more, but honestly, I'm scared. Like, I'm scared because I just don't know what's gonna happen. You know, like, because I come from a two-parent household. My parents are still together, and so I was super disappointed when I did find myself in this position. I know that God has already equipped me with everything that I need to be able to be in this position to make it through. I trust that and I have faith in that. It still doesn't mean that I'm not scared. I still have those feelings. Like, it's okay to have those, like, feelings of being, like, scared or anxious. But it's just, remember to recenter your focus around the fact that you will make it through.
I'm leaking.
Sorry.
I just realized how weird that's probably gonna be. I'm over here like, oh, I'm leaking.
I don't know why I get so excited. It's just, I don't know, the little things make me excited. It took me a while to find joy in a lot of this. When I tell y'all, like, yeah. I am, though, deciding, so I've decided to go no contact with my child's father, like, several times, and there were times where I tried to keep the contact, but just keep it, like, cordial. Like, if you ask me how I'm doing, I'll say good. I'm good. Thanks. Like, but it's not getting anywhere. Especially with somebody who is only being nice to get something out of you. A pregnant woman will never forget how she was treated during her pregnancy. I will never forget who has been there for me, who has texted me, checked up on me, who has given to me and my baby, who showed up to my baby shower, who, like, showed me any type of support, any type of love. I will never forget those people. And I'll also never forget who tried to make this experience miserable for me. I'll never forget the people who were not there for me, who said nothing, who did nothing. I'll never forget it. I have a forgiving heart. I can't hold on to grudges. I have no animosity towards these people and person. But for me and my life, and me and my peace of mind, and me and my baby's peace of mind, there's boundaries. And I feel like if pregnancy has taught me anything, it's gonna be about boundaries, setting boundaries, and you respecting them for yourself. Because you can't rely on other people to respect your boundaries, but you can respect your own boundaries. If you don't respect your boundaries, then you can never expect anybody else to. You have no control over other people's actions and what they choose to do and what they choose to not do, but you have every control of that boundary that you create between you and that person or between you and that thing. That's what you have control over, and that's what you got to stick to. And I never was the person to do that. And I'm so happy that this pregnancy taught me to set boundaries and keep them and respect them for yourself, even if other people don't. I'm so excited for motherhood. I unfortunately am still pregnant right now. I told y'all I hoped by the end of the week that I was gonna not be pregnant anymore, but here we are, drinking my water, doing everything I can. But just send me some love, send me some prayers, because I still do have a really hard time. I do not show a lot of it, but it's really hard for me, and I try so much to hide it, and sometimes you just can't. But then it's like, when there's another party involved, you also have to respect their life as well. So no matter how bad or how disrespected I may feel, or no matter how hurt I may feel, I am still going to be respectful of the other person involved. But let me know if you guys would like some more content just about me and how I'm navigating pregnancy without a partner, and how I'm going to be navigating motherhood and co-parenting and stuff like that. Parallel parenting. Oh, if you guys would like me to talk more about that, I definitely can organize my thoughts a little bit better. When I make these videos, I kind of just speak from my heart and my experience and my day. I don't really like plan what I'm gonna say. My brain just kind of goes. And every day is different. Like, some days I have really, really good days, and then some days it'll just be one thing that just makes it really, really difficult. It's Friday night. I am gonna cut this weekly vlog a little short just because since baby's gonna be here any day, I really just want to have a day where I do absolutely nothing. So tomorrow I'm literally doing nothing. I'm gonna be in the bed all day watching a show. I'll probably try to find a show or a movie to watch, and I'm just gonna relax. I'm gonna enjoy my dog. I'm gonna enjoy my family. My brother's home from school. I just really want to chill and live in the moment, do some reflection. I feel like I really need that because I've just been on go, 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 and it's been one thing after another. So yeah, I appreciate you guys respecting me and my life and what I have going on. I appreciate you for being here. I appreciate you for supporting me, really like being on this journey with me. It makes me feel really good. Like I said before, I'm really not a very social person, like when it comes to in person. So knowing that I can connect with people through just sharing my life, it makes me feel really good. So I really appreciate you guys giving me the opportunity to be here and to chat with you. But again, I hope in my next video I have a baby. Oh my gosh, like, doctor's appointment next Tuesday. They're doing my membrane sweep. And I hope I have a baby after that. We'll miss it just being me and him. I'll miss that a lot. But I hope you guys had an amazing week. I'm sending love your way. Thank you for being here, and I will talk to you soon.